Right, enough of the frivolity. In this video, as a change to the scheduled production, I'm going to have a little chat about my channel. It's my 1 month anniversary, and I thought I'd give you a bit of an update. If you're not interested in this bit, you can skip forward to the Grumpy Cat for the teaser for an actual workshop tool review, and then go and wait for that one. Otherwise, stay with me and we'll have a chat. So as of today, one calendar month since I launched the channel, it's already hit 358 views and over 21 hours of watch time. 24 of you have actually joined the channel, making me a total of 32. Now that may seem very tidgy to other creators, but it's making me very happy. Further, 10 of you are not anonymised and 4 of you are actually recognisable YouTubers in this genre in themselves. And 9 out of 10 of you have engaged with me in the comments section. I'm just blown away. What else? Oh yeah, I'm still learning and finding my way around the YouTube dashboard and the analytics. Most of this is still hieroglyphics to me and probably irrelevant anyway, considering the grumpy old workshop niche I'm in and the likelihood of me ever going viral, but I'm having fun playing with it, that's great. Oh, I found the monetization page. I think at 32 subs and 20 watch hours, I'm a little short for the minimum height requirements of 1,000 subs and 4,000 watch hours to get on that ride. Anyway, the stuff I'm learning is intriguing, and perhaps some of you can help me on this. For instance, my viewers are averaging watching only 50 to 60% of each video. Are you all fast-forwarding or skipping to the end or just getting bored and wandering off? I've no idea. I never fast-forward. Why would you even do that? Right, I found the channel contents page, and that's interesting too. It clearly showed my oldest clips have the most views, which is not surprising, but not always the most likes or comments. Luckily, nobody's disliked any of my videos so far or tried to take one down yet. So, all in all, I think it's a very good first month for an old dog like me learning new tricks. Now, speaking of new tricks, yes, my production values are pretty low and janky, and yes, I'm tending to try out all the cliched bells and whistles that iMovie and YouTube have available in the software. It's a novelty, and I get overexcited, hence the emoji taking over my ugly mug at the top of the channel. Don't judge me. Videoing, sound and lighting are still a little variable so far because I'm repurposing cameras and ambient lights meant for stills photography and not vlogging. This will improve as I swap stuff out over time. Now, the movie clips will get more consistent in terms of sound levels, colour rendition, titles, captions, storytelling in A and B rolls as I master the software and get into practice. Don't worry, I'll settle down and find my voice, whatever that means, PDQ. What are my plans for the channel for the rest of the year after the first month? If you saw my channel trailer, I do tend to ramble a bit, so I'll try to be a bit more concise. I'm going to be remodelling the workshop with the last tools I will ever need, including a legacy hand tool kit to pass on. So, more tool reviews over time. Learn new skills with the proper hand and power tools. In spite of 30 odd years in property and management, I was never on the tools and I have poor hand-eye coordination, so that's going to be fun. 3. I aim to spend a lot of the retirement time I have left as quality time in this workshop making nice stuff. I aim to record making this nice stuff to share with family and friends. That's you. It's the bucket list thing. I want to create a body of work in terms of heritage pieces and videos to pass on. Right. I've said this before, I've got to stress too that I'm really starting from scratch in terms of hand tool skills. This should be a real zero to hero journey, or at least be entertaining as you watch me try. I'm hoping to collect, in terms of channel subscriptions and viewers, I'm hoping to collect and encourage a small following of old fogies to get in their sheds and potter around torturing wood. Or maybe younger fogies, or forgets for that matter. You all welcome. To be honest, I've been made up with your responses and subscriptions so far, as I'm treating this channel as an open door on my workshop that friends and family can pop in when they want, see what I'm up to and have a chat. I really don't want to be in a situation where I'm having to set up automatic thanks responses in the channel. It's got to be personal and it's got to be genuine. So there we are. What's it going to say? Oh yeah, the Grumpy Cat's coming up next, and then there'll be a teaser for the actual workshop work before you go. I hope everybody stayed to see it. Let's crack on. Here we go. The published schedule was I was going to address sanding in the workshop. I'll go into more detail next, but this is the end result. Spoiler alert, I went with a clone of a belt and disc sander. There we are. Thanks for coming. Let's crack on.